What up? It's your buddy Mark coming with another Eminem, video song. No video actually, but keeping on the same theme. The last song is always a banger. This is on the Refill album. I don't know how many of you remember this one. It only had 8 songs, and the first song on it was the one with Drake, Kanye, Lil Wayne, and Eminem. And then, because they were going to do a Relapse too, but Eminem didn't like the way Relapse came out. And it's crazy to think about how different Relapse and Recovery are. And they're only a year apart. Just like Revival and Kamikaze. He's got so many R's, it's a tongue twister. Because there's also the re-ups. I'm going to do that next. And then there's Relapse, Refill, Recovery, Revival. Oh man, it gets me tongue twisted. But anyway, if you like this, please hit subscribe, and because I need some subs. But anyway, let's get to the music. This is Drop the Bomb on Them, 2009. This is a very different type of beat from Eminem at the time. Oh, this is a great beat though, I think. I got there some pauses. I didn't even know this little album. Also, I can't even call it an album or EP. Well, I don't know. It's 8 songs. And one of them is the one song that everyone heard of Kanye and Drake and everyone. But I didn't even know about this. And then this girl starts playing the song on the way home from a party. I was like, what's that? I was like, cause I thought I knew all Eminem shit. She's like, you didn't hear this little album he dropped called The Refill? Nah. It's good. We'll cover a couple, like 2-3 songs off it. But right now, let's keep with this one. Drop the Bomb. This is my favorite one anyway, because it's the last one. It's not always that way, but the last one's always fire. Can't even fill voids. Party's over, kids killing noise. They come to kill joys. Me and Dre to steal alloys. The rap crown royals and scout cowboys. Now, how that sound for you? Yeah, boy, you know we're about to put it down for you. So kick your shoes off and before you have a sound voyage. Sayonara, see you fuckers tomorrow. Get some R&R and marinade and some marinara. And have a coke and a smile. They'll make me open the jar. Whip ass on you, that's the last star you're hoping to draw. Yeah, you're fresher than most. Boy, I'm just doper than all. Boy, I'm that boy, boy. Them boys, them dogs to paw. I really like this one too, because after Relapse, he did so much accents, and then like this was kind of like this, I don't know, it's like there was no accents. It kind of sounded, with the Dre beat and him talking clearly, it sounded like, all right, I'm getting back to my old self. But I didn't know he was gonna drop Recovery like maybe 6 months after this.
Oh my God, boy, you didn't gotta know you did not. I got a whole storyboard. it for you, boy, you're the plot. You're getting got, whether you try to avoid it or not. Apology not accepted, boy, Detroit is a rock. We get the beef and ain't no telling at what point it'll stop. All I got to do is point to the spot. When the bomb drops, boy, it's a drop. But when it does, boy, it's a pop. The bomb on him, gonna drop the bomb on
him. He's gonna drop the bomb on him. Say, boil to it.
You got to run and tell someone else. Bringing hell, boy, stringing telegrams to get down. Instead of boy, I'm insensitive, mental said he was better. I bet you never seen Freddy in a black and red little sweater.
There he goes, talking with Freddy again. I think I remember Chasing X. The last one we did, he was taking out all the, I don't want to call them supervillains. I used to watch the superhero movies. The horror movie people said he had chased the 40s to the 40. He got in a fight with Freddy Krueger and Heir to Citizen Sands 2 and came out with a little scratch. Boo. Oh, man. Yeah, he really thinks he's a guest in hip hop. Yeah, sure he does. He was doing the chicken. He really sounded like he was getting back to his old self a little bit. Cause I was not a big fan of the Recovery album. I like it a lot more now than I did when it first came out. But when it first came out, the beat just keeps going. There's no more rapping. I was disappointed when it first came out. And a lot of people, it's so weird. Relapse and Recovery couldn't be any more different. Did I just say Recovery before? Maybe. But I meant to say Relapse. I wasn't a fan of Relapse when it first came out. But Relapse and Recovery couldn't be any more different. Some people say that Relapse was like the end of Shady. Then Recovery, he got off drugs, he was sober, and wasn't as good anymore. But I don't know. Some people, I don't know. His first three CDs are my favorite. But, you know, Recovery, boy, it had, like, the success of those songs, like Not Afraid, Love the Way You Lie, No Love, are huge. Like, talking billions on YouTube. I saw Love the Way You Lie broke the record for like a billion views on YouTube. Oh man, but yeah, those songs were like incredible, huge hits. And that whole album I really liked, except for like two songs, which is a great ratio, where Relapse, maybe I only liked 5-6 songs out of the 20. So it was a big switch for me. I liked Recovery a lot more. It's actually one of my favorite albums. It's between Recovery and Kamikaze, to where that 4 spot goes after his first 3 albums were made. Alright, I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, please hit a subscriber. I need some subs. Alright, peace.